தேர்தல் களம் தெலுங்கானாவில் ரொம்ப பரபரப்பாக ஓடிட்டுருக்கு. மாதவி லதா அவர்கள் ஏஐஎம்ஐஎம் கட்சியுடைய ஓவைசி எதிர்த்து தெலுங்கானாவில் களம் காண்கிறார் ஹைதராபாத்தில். How you are going to break this 40 years of AIM, particularly OIC family, and what is the change you are expecting on the ground?
First thing is, I don't find it really very difficult to break this 40 years of, the tyranny, I would say. Yeah. The 40 years of tyranny, it's not really to break, easy, not difficult to break, because end of the day, people have not really flourished, they've not prospered here. In fact, they're not even stagnated. They have traveled back into the underdevelopment time. So I would say that today the voters should know the truth, and they need a leader who knows the truth and who keeps the guts to open up with the truth. So they want a leader who's fearful, they want a leader who is daring, and they want a leader who has more a social service attitude with him or her. And that is the most important thing today, at least Hyderabad Lok Sabha Parliament candidate should have.
So here the Hyderabad voters, the larger part of voters is minorities. So is that a difficulty as a BJP candidate for you?
Absolutely no. In fact, I would say it is such a good factor to me, because I've been working all my years 70%, 60% with minorities only. It's a boon in a disguise for me, because I had been having very good relationship with them. Even till today I have very good relationship with them. This is what I would want to show to the entire country. Ultimately, end of the day, I have never worked keeping vote as a criteria in my life, because I'm a social worker. A social worker, I would think that, you know, if I do good to Hindu community, they'll give me vote. If I do good to Muslim community, they'll give me vote. This was never a criteria. But today, if it works, yes, it will work wonders.
So when I was talking with OYC, he said the bow and arrow issue, you know that. Do you think that might be a game changer on the ground?
I would tell that it's become a joke now, because I am worried. In the entire interview, you had only bow and arrow to talk about. Oh my God. He's a barrister and he talks about a bow and arrow in every interview. He should have had a better reason to talk about. He should have the poor and their atrocities to talk about. He should have, you know, the kind of Dalits and their problems to talk about. He should have women, their problems to talk about. He should have the underdevelopment, the problems to talk about. He should have the dirty drainages flowing out to talk about. He should have the technologically the constituency so bad and behind, he should have to talk about. He should talk about that why the land here is 8 times, 10 times less by its prices than its surrounding constituencies. That is what he's supposed to talk about. There are no schools, there are no colleges. That is what he's supposed to talk about. He's supposed to talk that engineering colleges which were there earlier in our constituency got shut down. Why? He should talk about. He have better things to talk about. Now, if he talks any more about bow and arrow, he'll just fall down from his situation, whatever he is. Further, he will fall down. That doesn't give him any great dignity, I believe.
The entire status, looking at three-dimension corner of election, the only constituency which has four dimension, what do you think on that? That is the floor which is AM BJP or Congress BJP or BRS BJP?
I would say that it is between the justice and injustice. It is about the truth that they would want to bring and the truth that the other person would want to hide. It is more about AMIM, Asaduddin, Akbaruddin, BJP, Madhavi Lata, and Modi ji. As simple as that. It's not about any religion. It's about the 40 years of atrocities that both brothers have given to Hyderabad Lok Sabha and the assemblies there.
How was the election throughout Telangana? You are traveling into Hyderabad and into your constituency. Do you have observed over Telangana? How it has been a flow for for
in the entire Telangana, our BJP candidates are doing wonders and they're working very, very hard. And coming to my constituency, I'm rocking. My voters are very excited. They're just, I think for the first time, all of us are waiting for May 13th to come as soon as possible.
3 days go to the polls. The campaign gets over within 3 days.
Yeah.
What do you want to comment on your Hyderabad people, particularly the voters?
I would say my voters are wonderful. My voters are very, very lovable and very affectionate. My entire voters are the citizens of this country and they deserve to get justice. The entire voters of my constituency for the 40 years are deprived of everything, right from basic amenities to the development. I have nothing to say directly to my voters because they and me are part of the entire 40 years of downtrodden journey that they also underwent, I also underwent. I am part of their family and they are part of my family. So we all want to work together on May 13th to bring fortune to Hyderabad Lok Sabha.
Okay, all the best for your elections, which is upcoming on 30th at the poll date. Cameraman Segarudan, News 18 Kaha, Subhash Prabhu.